propagandas first began 20 years ago.
Well, Bill, WrestleMania got started way back in 1985. The Breakfast Club and Back to the Future were blockbusters at the box office. Judge Wapner and the People's Court premiered. Madonna's Like a Virgin album was number one.
And I, Bill,
back it up.
One.
I was a mere 5 years old.
That's it. So you gave me all that other stuff, and all I asked you was, how old you were?
Yeah, also, New York, New York became New York City's official theme song in 1985.
What? I got nothing.
Collar elbow tie up. Shannon Moore with the go behind on Paul London. London perhaps going for a standing switch.
5 years old.
Yes.
How'd you know all that stuff?
Because actually 1985 is my favorite year. I'm an aficionado of the year 1985.
At 5 years old, you had a favorite year.
Sure, didn't you? Nice kip up there by Shannon Moore. The Chicago Bears. Super Bowl champions. There's a whole world out there, Bill. Come on. Now Paul London again taking the arm of Shannon Moore.
I asked one question. I got all that.
And of course at WrestleMania 20, it all begins again. And I cannot wait for tomorrow night. We're about, 21 hours away now, Bill, from WrestleMania 20. I can't wait. Shoulder tackle there by Shannon Moore. Moore off the ropes now.
1999.
What about 1999, Bill?
My favorite year.
Oh, drops off by Paul London. London into the cover, hooks the leg to it, a kick out wide. Bill, is 1999 your favorite year?
Because I can remember what happened in 99.
Can't remember any other ones?
I don't choose to.
Oh, back over there by Shannon Moore. And now, swing hit kick there by Paul London. London into the cover, hooks the leg to it, a kick out. Paul London, of course, not involved in the Cruiserweight Open tomorrow night at WrestleMania. London last week almost beat Jamie Noble, who is involved in the Cruiserweight Open. And right now, Paul London is putting the fight to Shannon Moore.
But why compete, Josh? Let me have your feelings. Why should Paul London come out here and compete for a match right before WrestleMania that he's not even involved in? I want your feelings. I'm not saying he's right or wrong. I want you to take me.
But, Bill, it's almost like the NFL. If you're a losing team in the NFL towards the end of the season, and you're playing a team that's going to the playoffs, that has a chance to go to the playoffs, you want to beat them and ruin their chances. So right here, Paul London wants to ruin Shannon Moore's chances of winning the Cruiserweight Championship tomorrow night at WrestleMania.
So you believe that if Paul London can beat Shannon Moore now, you think that Paul London can take Shannon Moore's spot?
Collar kick out there by Paul London. No, I don't necessarily know if that's what Paul London's thinking. But Paul London just right now, right here on Saturday night, wants to beat Shannon Moore. Cut by Shannon. A kick out there by Paul London.
Well, I'll tell you, I don't think there's any rules. Judging by this past week's SmackDown.
No doubt about that. It was Rey Mysterio one-on-one with Jamie Noble. Then all of a sudden, the referee turned it into an eight-man tag team match. Seven of the eight participants will be in the Cruiserweight Open tomorrow night at WrestleMania. And Bill, who do you think has the advantage of walking out of MSG tomorrow night, the Cruiserweight champion?
The same man walking in champion. Chavo Guerrero, in my opinion, will walk out the Cruiserweight champion simply because nine other men are trying to beat each other to get to Chavo Guerrero.
Yeah, but don't you think that Chavo Guerrero is a marked man? And since this is an elimination match, that Chavo will be one of the first superstars out of the match?
Before you get to Chavo, you have to eliminate your other competition. If all of them go for Chavo right at the get-go, then Chavo's going to walk away with him.
Tensions running high for Chavo Guerrero in the Cruiserweight Championship, and now, Shannon Moore. Just bouncing off of Paul London. Moore hits the ropes now, and a neckbreaker by Shannon. Cover puts the leg, and Paul London again, barely kicking out. And speaking of tensions, we saw it just a few minutes ago. The tensions between Kurt Angle and Eddie Guerrero is so thick, you could cut it with a chainsaw.
Did you see the look in Kurt Angle's eyes?
It's unbelievable. I mean, it's so intense. The intensity between Angle and Guerrero is off the chart. Cover by Shannon Moore after the red tail snapper and another kick out by Paul London. And they're going to collide. It's going to be Angle Guerrero. The WWE Championship hangs in the balance. These two are going to go at it tooth and nail, back and forth, until one of them walk out of Madison Square Garden with the WWE Championship.
Well, do you think this one's become so personal that almost the WWE Championship is secondary? They're calling each other out. There's personal issues involved here, Josh. We're talking about people's past, people's beliefs, the fans, the company, where everybody stands. And last but certainly not least, who should be the WWE champion?
That's a great point, Bill, but I think it all boils down to 16 pounds of gold, the WWE Championship. I mean, Kurt Angle lost the WWE Championship last year at WrestleMania 19. And I think when you lose something, you really realize how much you want that, how much you want it back. It's been a year. Now Kurt Angle wants to go in tomorrow night and win back that title from Eddie Guerrero.
Well, it's obvious how much this means to Kurt Angle just by what he's brought out into the open about himself, about our champion Eddie Guerrero, and about the company. Moral fiber, the country, the fans, his children. No holds barred.
It's going to be off the chart tomorrow night. Paul nails the waffle face on Shannon Moore. Lightning now rolls into the cover. Cuts the leg. Oh, and 2 3/4. Shannon Moore barely escaping. We talked about Kurt Angle, but what about Eddie Guerrero? Eddie Guerrero always been the underdog, always fought from underneath. And now Guerrero is the champion. And he will defend that championship tomorrow night, WrestleMania 20. London up on the top rope. Frog splash, high cross body. Got him. No. No. Shannon Moore kicked out.
I think Shannon Moore is wrestling on reserve tanks. He is not going to overindulge himself right now. He's taking Paul London lightly. You got to go for the win. I don't care if you're going into WrestleMania or not. Shannon Moore has to finish off Paul London if he wants to win in this match.
And now Paul London slingshot, sunset flip. Moore rolls through. And a drop kick to the face by Shannon Moore. You think Shannon Moore's holding back a little bit, Bill?
If I were Shannon Moore's position, I'd be holding back just a little bit. But Paul London's giving him such a run for his money, he better just bring his A-game right now.
Much like Paul London did last week with Jamie Noble.
Get it down.
London looking to make a name for himself in the cruiserweight ranks. Going for the Hurricane Rana. Shannon Moore just threw off Paul London. And now Shannon from the second rope.